Hello and welcome. I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris Effect, and we're going to be looking at Sapphire's Builder and one of the new presets added in Sapphire 2021, Quick Text Effect, a highly flexible preset that can create more interesting text looks out of plain white type. In After Effects, we've set up our little composition, and this is probably the most basic composition that we could have. I've got a background clip and I've also got a plain text layer. So we're going to use the Sapphire Builder to very quickly make some more interesting text. Now, this isn't going to be a replacement for doing heavy stylized text creation, but it is a fast way of making our text look a little bit nicer without doing a whole load of work. So if I come into my effects and presets and just type S underscore effect, it will pop up with a Sapphire Builder effect, which I can then just drag on. And every time we put a Builder effect onto something, nothing changes because Builder is like a blank canvas when we start. So the first thing I'm going to do is go into my preset browser. And in the preset browser, I can go into Builder effects and have a look at all the different effects that I have available to me. So we have things that are, you know, working on text like Halloween text or Halt and Catch Fire. This is quite a fun little effect there for playing around with our text. We have also have a whole load of motion background stuff. And if I just type in text into the search, this will start to show us some of the presets that are to do with text. Obviously, this is going to bring up textures as well. So if instead of text, I actually just put in type, we'll have a look at our type effects now. And we have one here that's called Quick Text Effect. So I'm just going to load that in. And what the Builder does is it gives us the ability to chain different Sapphire effects together. So all of these that we have here are based on regular Sapphire effects. It's just we have them all in one nice, handy, little compact area. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change my tint color here. And let's come in, let's use the eyedropper, and let's just grab it from the background. And that's what the tint does. The tint allows us to very quickly change the color of the text. We also have a linear gradient, which gives us the ability to add a bit more kind of depth to the effect. Let's bring that around here. I have my controls over on the left-hand side with the start color and the end color. But where if we have the widget in the individual effect, we will also have the widgets here in our Builder effect. So I can come in and I can maybe add a little bit more of a nice linear gradient. There we go. Give it a bit of an angle. Get nice, a rakish tilt. So that's our linear gradient. At the top here, we also have the ability to add a bit of text grunge. So this is a simple case of bringing up the stamp density, and we can then put in a bit of texture in here. And we can change things like the relative densities of the different stamps, which we have here all along. So we have like quite a lot of different things that we can put on, but all of that is, you know, contained within the stamp density. I can back that off a little bit by taking the stamp opacity down. We also have the edge warp to add grunge to the edge. I'm not going to be touching that too much. Same with the edge grunge depth. That's quite a tricky one to say. We can shrink and grow that a little bit here. And you can see that that kind of gives us a slightly different texture. When I send that into the negative, that gives us a slightly different texture there. So if I turn the before and after, there we go. Get a nice little different look. I'm going to set my edge grunge density back down to zero again. We have emboss with shininess on it. So that just helps to build up, again, some of the idea that this is a bit more 3D than it actually is. Nice, very simple. Cool. And I'm going to skip over Distort Chroma and come back to that in a little second, because at the bottom we have our glow. And our glow just adds, yeah, nice bit of glow. By default, it's set to glow under the source. If you want it to glow over the top, we can just set that to zero. But I think that that gives us a nice little plinth to build our text on top of. That's our little glow there. Lovely. So you can see how easy it is to sort of take our text and start to build up some different stuff with it. But it goes further than that. You know, especially with something like the text grunge, you might not want this particular style of grunge here, but we don't have any controls in the main effect controls to be able to change any of that. Well, that's why we can just come in and go edit quick text effect. So edit the effect. And this takes us into the effect builder properly. And here we can start to see how this is actually built up. And most of the builder presets, if they have any sort of complexity to them, will have, you know, text things to guide you through what is actually going on. Over on the left-hand side here, we can see this is where the edge grunge happens. In the middle, this is where the tint and grunge overlay happens. And over on the right-hand side, it's where everything starts to get combined and adds the emboss and glows. And we have a nice little instructions to take you through if you get lost, which is basically what we did here. You know, start with the tint, add the gradient, add the additional elements like the text grunge, the emboss, and then adjust the edge grunge depth. But what if we want to change any of these? Well, I can go onto any of these effects and we get the full version of the Sapphire controls over here. So this is the full Sapphire effect. So at this point, I can come in and say, well, I don't want my first stamp to be plaster. I'd rather have that to be scratches. And if I come to my stamp 2 details, come down here, I don't want my stamp 2 to be hairline cracks. I would rather have that being, I don't know, corrosion. And those have been updated and will change how it works in After Effects. What I can also do here is I can change any of the parameters that I want to see in After Effects as well. As you can tell, there are check marks next to the parameters that we can see back in our host. If I wanted to add something to it, say for example, I wanted to change my stamp 1 colors, I just have to select those there. And if I hit OK, when we come back into the host UI, not only will it have updated with the new grunge elements, but I will also have my stamp colors that I can change right here. So I can come in, let's see if any of these hues will actually make a difference. I wouldn't expect actually these to make a big difference in what we're doing in this particular case, but you know, there we go. There was probably a reason why these weren't turned on in the first place, but we can turn them on and we can change stuff up. So again, this is the before and this is the after. We can build this up really easily. The nice thing about this is we can also change the look very quickly as well. If I don't want any of that stamp stuff, I can just take my stamp density down to 0. Keeps this a bit cleaner. I can change my, let's change this over here to maybe something a bit redder. There we go. A bit more purple, I should say. And let's take the glow brightness all the way down. And we can have a look at the one that I didn't see before, which is the Distort Chroma. So we can just add a bit of chroma distortion in there. Again, this is an effect that probably works better at lower levels. Just helps to kind of, yeah, break the text up a little bit. We can go extreme and we can warp things up. And we've got tons of little options we can do with this here. Bring my glow back in. Any point, maybe just change the color again. There we go. And this is one of the nice things about having this preset, the quick text effect preset, because it gives you enough variety to start to build up some different looks without you having to go in and make a lot of different choices or get too deep into building up multiple layers or manually adding in lots of different effects, because they're all just, you know, here for you. Let me just undo a couple of times, take us back there. I would make a quick RAM preview. And that really is the beauty of Builder. You can start with a preset that gives you enough to begin your effect. And if you do want to go deeper, then you have the tools to be able to go in and customize things nice and easily as well. And if you haven't used the Sapphire Effect Builder, now is the perfect time to do it. There are always new presets being added to it, In Sapphire 2021, not only did you get the quick text effect, there's also a quick film effect and an instant motion background preset added as well, as well as all the different types of presets that have already been in there, and I'm sure you'll find something to inspire or use in your next project. Thanks for watching. If you want to learn more about Sapphire's Builder or any of the Sapphire effects, then head on over to borisfx.com. Here you can find the latest product news, a whole host of free video tutorials, and free trials for every single Boris Effects product.